Namaste. Today's topic is karma. And there are three types of karma. Prarabdha karma, Kriyaman karma, and Sanchit karma. What is the difference between these three types of karmas? And Saturn represents all of these three karmas. In your chart, the Prarabdha karma is represented by Saturn. Karma always follows you. No matter where you go, whatever you have done will catch you today or tomorrow. There was a very rich man and there was a very poor man too. And both lived in the same city, and one day both died. The poor man went to heaven and the rich man went to hell. And the rich man was surprised, he was shocked. He looked at that poor man and he was sitting near God. And so the rich man said to God, "There seems to be some problem. I should be there in the heaven and that poor man should be here in the hell." God laughed and said, "Those who are last will become first, and those who are first will become last. You have enjoyed enough. Now let the poor man enjoy too." The rich man felt very hot. Of course, in hell, you don't have any air conditioning. It was burning hot. He felt very thirsty, but there was no water. So he cried again and said to God, "Please send someone to fetch me some water. I am feeling very thirsty. Please." And God said, "That poor man, Jonathan, was also thirsty several times. And he used to come at your door asking for water, asking for food. And you and your servant would drive him away. And then there were many VIP people coming at your home. Ministers, mayors, and they were not hungry, but Jonathan was hungry. You and your servants chased him away. You never looked after him. Now it is impossible. I cannot let you have water." And it is said that Jonathan, the poor man, laughed. He laughed out loudly. And this became a deep mystery, a deep puzzle for many pundits and scholars, that why the poor man Jonathan laughed. He laughed at the absurdity of the things. He never knew that a nobody like Jonathan, a poor man, a homeless man, would find a place in heaven. And he could not even imagine that the rich man, the richest man in the town, would find a place in hell. And so he laughed. He laughed out loudly. And Jonathan still laughs. And he will laugh when you will die too. If you are a somebody, he will laugh, because you will be thrown out. If you are a nobody, he will laugh, because you will be received with open arms. Arrogance, anger, and jealousy are a byproduct of ego. And this ego that says, "I am somebody," comes out of things that are not everlasting. Money, status, position, all these things are temporary. A wise person is never stuck in all these temporary things. Always remember this. In this world, because ego exists, all valuations belong to ego. In the other world, the spiritual world, value belong to egoless qualities. Karma is like this. The rich man never offered water or food to Jonathan. After death, he goes to hell and there is nobody to serve him water because God reminds him of his karma. That when Jonathan was hungry, he was thirsty, he was asking for water at your doorstep, you drive him away. This is how karma comes back. Even a saint has not been able to escape from karma. What to say about you and me? In a market, in a crowded market, a small child finds his or her mother. No matter how many women are there in that shopping mall or in that market, if the child is lost, the child will find his or her mother. Similarly, no matter where you are, your karma will find you. There are many people who do certain karma behind the curtains. They think that nobody will come to know. But they are living in an illusion. Bhram. When time comes, their karma will catch them and make them pay for what they have done behind the curtains, meaning secretly. So you don't have to worry about your enemies. If they are doing something from behind the curtains, and if they are trying to be too smart, remember my words, they will get back what they have done in multiplication. Whatsoever you do comes back to you in multiplied form. There is a beautiful story, a real life event. When Lahiri Mahasay was going for a bath in a nearby river, and a disciple was following him. On the way, Lahiri Mahasay said to his disciple, "Do you have a piece of cloth?" The disciple said, "Yes, master, I have it." Lahiri Mahasay said, "Then keep it, we will need it." And then he went to the river, he had his bath, and as he was coming back home, suddenly a stone caused harm to his toe, to his feet, and it started bleeding. At that moment itself, Lahiri Mahasay said to the disciple, "Now you use that piece of cloth as a bandage." So the disciple applied that cloth like a bandage. But the disciple later on asked that, "Master, if you were aware of what is going to happen, then why you didn't avoid it?" And Lahiri Mahasay smiled and said, "Beta, nobody has been able to avoid the karma that is coming your way. But if you know, if you can understand what is coming your way, then you can remain prepared. And that is why I told you that keep a cloth with you, keep a piece of cloth ready with you. So a great master like Lahari Mahasaya, who was the guru of Yukteswar Giri, and Yukteswar Giri was the guru of Paramahamsa Yogananda, such a great master, if he is not able to avoid the karma coming on his way, then what to say about you and me and our enemies? Many such insights I have shared in this podcast. Many times it happens that you are in love with somebody, but you end up getting married with someone else. Why this happens? The answer you will find in this podcast. So let's begin. Karma is of three types. But before I explain you the three types of karma, I will first give you example of a book. The whole book is Sanchit Karma. The chapter in that book is Prarabdha Karma. And when you are actually reading a specific chapter, when you are on a specific page of a chapter, that page is your Kriyaman Karma. So now you understand. Prarabdha Karma is just one life, one birth. Sanchit Karma is an accumulation of the whole story of your births and rebirths. So whatsoever you are going through right now in this birth is your Prarabdha Karma. And your day-to-day karma is your Kriyaman Karma. That is why I gave you the example that the whole book, that is the whole story of your birth and rebirth cycles, is what is Sanchit Karma. Whereas just a chapter in that book, that is just one birth, is what Prarabdha Karma is all about. And Kriyaman Karma is the ongoing karma which is seen through the transit of Saturn and other planets. So now coming back to the horoscope, Prarabdha Karma is based on the placement and quality of Saturn in your birth chart. Whereas Kriyaman Karma is based on the transit of Saturn in your birth chart. Sanchit Karma is the total. And the charts that we cast is not total. It is for this birth, and therefore we call it birth chart. So precisely for this birth, only two positions of Saturn become critical to our existence. Natal Saturn, that is the placement of Saturn in your birth chart, and transiting Saturn. Quality and nature. Understand this. And I appeal to all my listeners. This is significant. A girl looks beautiful, very beautiful. Her eyes, her cheeks, her nose, her color complexion, everything is beautiful. So much so that you just can't ignore her looks. You have to appreciate her beauty.
Now this is the quality of her facial appearance. She is beautiful and there is no second thought about it. Now comes the next question. How is her nature? And many times nature goes for a toss. And by the time the boyfriend is aware of her nature, he is already caught, trapped in her clutches, and now there is no way out. So similarly, the zodiac sign represents the quality, while the nakshatra represents the overall nature. Now having both in good books is a matter of your prarabdha karma. Whenever you have a beautiful girl that also has a good nature, you are a blessed man. Then your material life is a super hit movie. Similarly, when you have a quality sign having a suitable nakshatra for Saturn, then your birth chart rocks in the true sense. So understand the fact that sign and nakshatra have to complement the related planet, then be it Saturn or any other planet. But now, since we are talking about Saturn, it has to do more with the quality and nature of your karma. Let's take the example of a hypocrite woman. And I see many of them almost every day. So let us take this example. Now a hypocrite woman wants to donate something so that she feels good and gets some attention from society. Now in the name of donation, she will buy some inferior quality grains, rice, and donate them to an orphanage. Now here, the nature of giving is recorded, but at the same time, quality of giving is also recorded. So here Saturn will fall in an ordinary quality sign with a nakshatra that is positive by nature. So what will happen then? Then this woman may progress, but her progress will be limited to peanuts. Whereas a woman who truly donates with an open heart, a quality food, she will progress in leaps and bounds, because in her case, the sign also will be of good quality and also the nakshatra will be of superior nature. So many times people wonder that why I am not getting promotion when my teammate is getting, and he has not done a great job than I have done. Remember, doing a job is a mechanical process. That is why I always say that when hiring a person, don't just look at his skills, because skills can be learned. What matters is the nature and quality of the person that you are hiring for a certain job. We all go for shopping, but have we noticed which shopkeeper does well? Which shopkeeper attracts more customers? And moreover, why a certain shop attracts more customers? It has all to do with the nature and quality of the shopkeeper. In Pune, if you go to the Jangli Maharaj Road, that is JM Road, just opposite the Jangli Maharaj Mandir, there is a long line of shops, and all of them are mobile shops, almost all. And yet only one shop has more customers than the rest of them. Incidentally, I had bought my first mobile from this shop. And till date, I always have been buying from the same shop, because the owner is a very positive person. He smiles, he is proactive, and moreover, he cares for each and every customer who visits his shop. When you buy a product from a shop, you are directly relating to the owner of that shop. And this is a very deep subject. When you buy a brand, you are directly relating to the energy of that brand. But people don't understand this. They just go to any shop and buy. Buying and selling is not robotic. It has a very deep relation, a very deep relating to it. Always visit a shop that attracts more customers, because it simply means that the shop has more positivism to it. Always buy a brand that does well in the market. It simply means that the energy of that brand is too positive. And by buying that brand, you can also experience the positivity of that brand. One has to be conscious of buying a brand product, and also from where to buy, because of the shopkeeper or the shop from where you buy matters above all. In the old days, many of you may have heard that our old grandfather would always say that if you are buying a certain product, then buy from a specific shopkeeper. But then we would wonder, why only that shopkeeper when there are so many others who are selling the same product on the same street? But old people have experiences that we don't have. And so many times when they tell us something, it is for our benefit. That is why brand matters. And I have absolutely no hesitation in admitting that yes, one has to be brand conscious, because brands have a legacy, and legacy have a certain quality and nature to its existence. Quality is a zodiac sign. Nature is the nakshatra. Always remember, planets are not your friends. Understand this. As long as the planets remain, the cycle of birth and rebirth continues. A great yogi from the Himalayas, to whom I had met a few years ago, had said, "Now there is nobody in my birth chart, but only me, the self." The planets are simply the significator of our prarabdha karma. So as long as the planets remain active, the karmic cycle of birth and rebirth, happiness and sadness continue. When the great yogi said there are no planets in his birth chart, he meant that now he has risen above all his planets that are nothing but your karma. How does that happen? Through meditation. What is the way? The way is inward. What should I do? You should turn inwards. That is why in the coming year, in the next year, I am again coming with a new book titled Come Back Home. Because unless you return back to yourself, unless you start turning inwards, there is no way that you can diffuse your karmic cycle. And so, instead of focusing on this planet in this house, I would love to see you all focus more on how you can overcome the prarabdha karma by being more understanding and more meditative. Self-inquiry is the greatest quality that you can develop within yourself. The moment you start self-inquiring, you are on a new path, the path of real progress, the path of real growth. Bhagwan Raman Maharshi says, "Your own self-realization is the greatest service you can render the world." The more you turn inwards and self-inquire, the more you would be able to stand against all the odds and challenges of your life. Saturn is generally soft towards a woman. A woman is far superior to a man. By nature, a woman has more love than a man. The man may say, "I think I love you," to a woman. But a woman functions from the heart. She cannot say, I think I love you. It has never been heard in the history of mankind that a woman saying something like this. A woman simply says, I love you. There is absolutely no role of the head, no place for thinking. The heart needs no help from the head. The heart is enough to share the purest feeling, the feeling of being in love. Saturn has a role to play when it comes to love. A person with good placement of Saturn generally is found to be a man or a woman of ethics. As long as she or he is in a relationship, they remain totally committed to their relationship. Generally, a good Venus brings along a long-term relationship, and a good Saturn brings along a long-term marriage. Wherever there is legality involved, Saturn has a role to play. Wherever there is society involved, Saturn has a role to play. So relationships can go well as long as Venus is good. The fifth house lord is transiting well, and everything is hunky-dory. The moment Venus is shadowed by Rahu and the fifth house lord is trapped in some negative planetary influence, be it transit or antardasha, the relationship starts getting cracks. Venus is like a bird. Now it is here and now it is gone. And so relationships are generally short-lived. The moment a relationship transforms into a marriage, Saturn jumps in. Now the whole scenario has changed. Now the sense of responsibility has come in. Now the woman with whom you had an affair is no more just a girlfriend. Now she is your wife. Now you cannot just message her, I am leaving you. If you do so, Saturn the legal master will bang on your head. Earlier, it was just her. You had to answer only to her. But now with marriage, there is the whole army of family you would have to answer. So you see, Saturn makes things sticky. You cannot just get up and say, I am leaving you. The next moment you will be surrounded by society and the family. Society is represented by Saturn. So when it comes to love relationship, Venus is your master. When it comes to sustaining your marriage, Saturn is your master. Many times it happens, and it happens almost across the world, that the boyfriend loves you but cannot marry you, or the girlfriend loves you but cannot marry you. This is not her problem, it is your problem. Your Saturn, Prarabdha Karma, is not supportive of something as durable and as sociable as marriage. There was one girl. She was in deep love and she had a beautiful relationship. They were almost mad in love. But when it came to the question of marriage, the same old story of fights between the two families, the opposition, the war. But finally, they got married. But exactly after 1 year, they also got divorced. The girl had her natal Saturn with Rahu, and the boy had a transiting Saturn with Rahu. Natal Saturn with Rahu is Prarabdha Karma, and transiting Saturn with Rahu is Kriyaman Karma. So Saturn plays a very important role in marriage, and Venus plays a very important role in love relationships. Being romantic and having a strong sexual drive are two different things. Venus in watery signs make you romantic, but Venus in fire signs scales up your sexual desire. Venus in earthy signs likes to have practical sexual experiences than fantasizing sexual desires. They simply want it right now. सो साइंस प्ले एज मच अ रोल एज द नक्षत्रा प्लेस. दे आर इंटरडिपेंडेबल. Whenever Saturn is in a sign that vibrates positively to its energy, Saturn does not delay or deny. Rather, Saturn brings responsibility to the matter of the house in which it is placed. This woman has Saturn in fifth house, and within 1 year of her marriage, she became the mother of a sweet boy. But the story does not end here. The main point is yet to be revealed, and the point is that her Saturn was in Libra, a sign that is perfectly positive to Saturn. So then, here Saturn has not delayed the childbirth. Here Saturn has given a male child, and on top of that, put more responsibility of the child on her shoulders by making her a single mom. So Saturn is not your enemy. Saturn is a planet that can bring great awareness to you, enabling you to transform and evolve into a much matured person, a stronger person. Being a single parent makes you stronger than ever before. So you see, Saturn does cause a certain pain, but this pain is not to hurt you, but rather to awaken you to your real potential. Saturn wants you to know that you can do more, you can rise above all. It is necessary to remember that people become alert only when the arrow goes deep into their heart and wounds them. It is only when a certain pain comes in your life, when you get a certain shake-up, a certain shock, that you wake up. Then you start evolving. Then a certain level of consciousness comes to your life. So all the pain and all the difficulties of this Prarabdha Karma, that is the natal Saturn, is simply to help you evolve into a much better human being, a much evolved soul. Why you should meditate? Because when you are being hurt by your own Prarabdha Karma, that is your own Saturn placement in your birth chart, and also sometimes along with natal Saturn, the transiting Saturn, that is the Kriyaman Karma, then chances are that you may go into depression, and that is natural. You may also become self-destructive. To help you from falling into these miseries of life, the only way for you is to sit down and spend some quality time with yourself by being more and more meditative. Worrying is of the mind, so you have to first control the monkey mind. And the only way to control the mind is through deep meditation. By focusing on only one thought, one name, the name of the Holy Lord, the Holy Mantra. Meditation is sticking to one thought. That single thought keeps away other thoughts. Distraction of mind is a sign of its weakness. By constant meditation, it gains strength, says Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi. Meditation happens only when there are no thoughts, but only one thought, one name, the name of the Holy Lord that you concentrate on. Then the mind will slowly come into your control. When you are troubled and when you feel lost, just close the door of your room and sit down. Close your eyes and meditate. Chant the holy mantra. Use an incense stick and lit a diya, a lamp, to add more positivity to your environment. This human life will continue to bring many good and bad experiences to you. But as your meditation will become more and better, the outward circumstances will no more impact your inward peace. To all, I insist that you spend a minimum of 20 minutes in deep meditation, in chanting the holy name of the Lord every morning before 7 a.m. The core essence of meditation is to stop all your thoughts and focus on your breathing as you deeply concentrate on your Lord's holy name. Meditation means the end of thinking, stoppage of flow. Concentration means only one point remains without any thinking about it. Along with meditation comes your act of random kindness. You have to balance your life by being meditative and also by being helpful. One of the greatest spiritual master whom I love the most, Avatar Meher Baba, says, "No amount of prayer or meditation can do what helping others can do." Balance, that's what Saturn likes. And that's why Saturn is most comfortable and exalted in a sign of balance, that is in the sign of Libra. Many men and women get confused when it comes to spiritualism. They think they have to live everything: sexual life, good food, good car, children and everything, and just focus on spiritual practice. That is totally wrong. If you are married, enjoy your sexual life. Do not make your wife or husband suffer because you have suddenly turned up to spiritualism. Make love to your wife or your husband. Play with your children. Do your job with utmost efficiency and dedication. And while you do all of this, also spend a minimum of 20 minutes in deep meditation, in deep prayers. If possible, stretch the time as per your convenience. That is called balance. And that is how, by balancing your life, you keep moving a step ahead in your spiritual journey, and not by renunciation and escaping to the Himalayas. The Divine Master, Mahavatar Babaji, says, "Even in the world, the yogi who faithfully discharges his responsibilities without personal motive or attachment treads the sure path of enlightenment." Saturn simply wants you to go through your karmic balance by being courageous and truthful. Once a great yogi had said that just the way a calf recognizes its mother from a thousand cows, similarly, your karma comes all the way following you, no matter where you are, no matter what you do. So focus on controlling your mind. Still the monkey mind. To a mind that is still, the whole universe is available. A mind that is fast is sick. A mind that is slow is sound. A mind that is still is divine, says the Divine Master Avatar Meher Baba. Do not worry about the future. Do not bother about the past, because life is neither in the past nor in the future. Life is now, in the present moment. If you are able to be here now, only then you are able to live your life in totality. The great spiritual master Paramahansa Yogananda says, "Live quietly in the moment and see the beauty of all before you. The future will take care of itself." Meditation happens only when you are able to be here now. When you are able to bring your mind in the present moment, and to do so, breathe in and breathe out. And simply make an effort to be here now, in this present moment. Now is the moment. Life is flowing in this now moment. Your goal should be to be here now. and that's the real beginning of your spiritual journey. Meditate. Jai Sri Ganesha, Jai Guru.